Hi everyone, my name is Sal.
My name is Lane.
And welcome to our first vlog. First of all, we'd like to thank everyone who is tuning in and also just to let you guys know how grateful we are for the overall support.
So I thought we'd start it with a Samoan language game. No, it was on pretty plastic, on plastic Samoan.
Yeah.
And so she,
yeah.
Plastic. So how this game works is we're going to give each other a word in English and the other person has to translate it in Samoan. And if you get it right, then you get a point. And obviously it's got to be a word that you know.
How many rounds is there?
So we'll do like five?
Yeah, five.
I'll go first.
Okay.
So your first word is light.
Light?
Mm.
So light in Samoan is moli.
Not moli.
Do I have to put it in a sentence?
Hey, if you want.
Nah. So your word is che.
Che, holy
shit. 5 seconds, 5,
4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, right. No, 4. Alrighty, your word is, man, it has to be words that I know. I only know the easy ones.
Yeah, because I could be telling you something different and you'd be like,
Stop your leaking. Let's go. Shower.
Oh, shower. Shower. Oh my goodness, how do you say shower? This guy, Ele, why do you say shower in Samoan?
Oh, that's what I thought it was, got Ele.
Oh yeah, but is it? I don't know. Ele's like washing your body. Like, you know, just having a...
Yeah, well, you just say something to go help Gaeli.
But do you mean like the shower as in the...
Oh, shower, just a shower.
Oh, Ele then.
Hey.
More 2 points to me. I'll give you food.
May I?
Everyone knows that word. I just wanted to give you an easy one.
Sugar.
Suka. It is. Suka. Your one is fridge.
Oh. Channel my inner Samoan. So.
So did your inner Samoan tell you what it is?
Yeah. Frick, I think I know it, man.
Refrigerator. Woo! So do you pass?
I don't know.
It's Busa Asa. Busa Asa.
Oh, yeah. Plug.
Ooh, plug. Oh, it's easy. Balaka.
So useless in this game.
I'll give you an easy one.
Yeah.
Car.
Cavale solo. It's the cavale.
Yay!
Easy. So I think I won that one.
Yeah. No, I think I won it because you passed out on Pusaisa. Yeah.
We're all winners at the end of the day. As long as you have fun,
Yep.
So that was our little icebreaker, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. Now we're going to get into the questions that were sent in to Sally on Instagram and other stuff from you guys. And it's just about, you know, get to know us a bit better. And,
But yeah, just before we get into our questions sent in by our viewers, we'd like to give you a little reason why we're starting our vlogging journey.
Your vlogging journey?
Yeah.
I didn't even want to
first
do this.
Of all, it was
help
pretty
me.
Much yeah, it was pretty much my idea. I pretty much roped Lane into it. I just watching polytubers on YouTube has influenced me to start vlogging myself. Just to mention a few, like CLC in Victoria, Solende, they're new, so Solende. Check them out. At Life, is it Tux and Sarah?
Tux and Sarah.
Yeah, the V Family.
V Family.
So yeah, those are some of the vlogs that we've been following, and yeah, just pretty much influenced me to share a bit of my world on YouTube with you guys. And yeah. Yep, so just before we get into our questions, just five fun facts about ourselves.
Yep.
Lane, go first.
Well, I'm 26. Mm-hmm. I was born in New Zealand. I moved here to Sydney in 2010. I like dancing. I like food.
Yep.
And I love computer games.
Cool. Yep. So my five fun facts are that I am 28. Yes, I'm 2 years older than Lane. I love playing rugby. I love anything footy. I am, was born in NZ, raised in Australia, and I come from a big ass family. So yeah, those are five fun facts.
And how many in your family?
11. But yeah, no, let's get into our questions now, which I have over here in our box.
My lunchbox.
And in Lane's lunchbox. And first question, Lane, you want to pick out?
Yep.
Cool.
First question is from Shari. Thank you, Shari. What are three things that you love most and annoy you the most about each other? So three things all up?
Yeah, three things that you love and three things that that annoy.
Sally is very bubbly. She's very caring and she's very selfless. And things that annoy me about her is she's easily frustrated. She swears a lot. She's angry.
Yeah.
Nah, that's it. And she makes up these like scenarios in her head when I go like she'll like text me and I'm like, who did you kiss?
No, I didn't.
I'll show you my messages.
Okay, three things that I love most about Lane is he's really good with Athena. He's a really good dad. Second thing is when he puts his mind to something, he's really good at it. And yeah, he works for our family. So that's three things. And three things that annoy me about Lane. I hate when he farts. In the room, everywhere. When he plays his game, like, without even asking us, like, through the whole weekend. There's no family time, just game. I think I only have two, so yeah. Okay. Okay, our next question is from Evans. How long were you guys talking, dating, before you guys introduced each other to the family?
I think Sally met my family
really early.
Yeah, I think maybe a couple months, like 3 months or 4 months into like dating. I didn't meet Sally's family for like over a year. Hey.
Yeah.
So we've been going out, talking for like a whole year.
Yeah.
And she was like staying at my place for a little bit.
Yeah, but my parents knew that
yeah.
I had a boyfriend.
But I just never met them.
Yeah. So our next question is anonymous. And it says, what's it like being parents compared to when you guys were just dating? Can I answer?
Yeah. Well, we had a lot more freedom.
Yeah.
You know, to do whatever we wanted. And see each other, like, when they're up. I don't like see each other, but, like, do things like we wanted to do. And now, as having a baby and having someone that you have to take care of and tend to their every need, we don't really have the time to tend to each other's needs.
Oh, well, we do, but, like...
Yeah, we do our best, I guess.
But, like, we have someone else to care for more than ourselves, yeah. And we have the responsibility of taking care of them, making sure that their upbringing is good and, yeah.
Mm.
But yeah, that's the difference, I guess, more responsibility.
Mm, more freedom. Yeah.
Less freedom for us. So our next question is from Zora. Thanks, Zora.
Zora.
How old were you when you had your first celebrity crush and who was it?
Celebrity crush. I'm trying to think back to when I was young. I can't really think of anyone from when I was young, but now, like, I'm 26. I'm 26 and I have a crush on Janae Aiko.
So, yeah, I would have been in my teen years, and I think I had a big celebrity crush on Jonathan Thurston and Justin Hodges. So, yeah, those were my celebrity crushes.
That's alright. That's nice. All right, I'll pick one up. So this question is from Gato and Alex.
Yeah.
How did you guys meet? We met on Twitter. So I think Sally followed me first. We started talking on Twitter and then and through Snapchat, and then I met her in St. Andrews.
Yeah.
I was clubbing with my cousins Billy and my mate Moana, my best mate. We were clubbing, and then after that, I drove all the way to St. Andrews.
Yeah, because
I was in Camden.
You in Camden, yeah.
Yeah, and then I drove to St. Andrews and met up with her.
Yeah.
And yeah, and then we talked and talked till the morning.
And it was funny because I remember when Lane said he wanted to come and watch me play rugby.
Oh, yeah.
And his cousin Alex wanted to ask the question. Took him to come and see me and pointed me out on the field, which I thought was so weird because I was trying my best not to get high tackled.
I met Sally and I came and watched the game, watched her play, and then I'd like just gapped it after
that. I know, you didn't even stop.
Because I saw her smashing everyone on the field and I said, nah, I don't want that.
But yeah, that was just a little fun story about that. Yeah. So, our next question.
What song always gets you out on the dance floor? That's from Zora. Seeing as I'm a bit of a dancer myself, anything from Chris Brown or any like old school R&B, like, doesn't matter if it's a slow jam, I'll still go out on the dance floor and just...
Yeah, I agree. So I'm saying, I think anything will get you out on the dance floor, well, me, but like when you hear a Chris Brown song, But yeah.
Well, you get your own.
I like folk songs too.
For sure.
Next one is from Evans. What areas do you come from?
You go first.
So I'm from Campbelltown. So basically I'm from Claymore, 2559 Klecker. Like a shack.
But you went like this.
Yeah, because now I'm in the 70.
I'm from originally from New Zealand, Auckland, Otara, South Auckland. So I was brought up, born and raised. Then I moved here to Sydney. I moved to pretty much the Otara of Sydney. This is Mount Druitt. I moved here and I've been here ever since. What are your hobbies and how did you get into them? From Zora.
Thanks, Zora.
Hobbies are dancing and gaming are my two main hobbies. Dancing, I got into when I went to high school or college, as they call it in New Zealand. I got into it through a mate. We had dance class together. One of my best mates, even to this day, Joseph. Shout out to you also. He pretty much got me into dancing. And then I thought about it. Like even when I was younger, I used to love dancing too. But then, like it didn't really hit me until college. And with gaming, gotten my mum's brothers, my uncles. They got me into games at a young age. I think I was playing like Counter Strike and that when I was like 6 years old. And yeah, I've loved it ever since.
Yeah. Apparently a lot of people say that Lane's a good dancer, but I've never witnessed it myself, so.
I've danced plenty of times in front of her, I think.
Yeah, but like every time like your friends are like, have you seen Lane dance? And like, no, and they go like, oh my gosh, I'm like.
100-0, baby, 100-0.
Yeah. Yeah, so my hobbies were sports. I've always loved them, especially rugby and league, because growing up I was always surrounded by my brothers and they played football, so it was only natural for me to follow along in their footsteps, which my brothers were my inspiration. Yeah, so my hobbies were footy. Yeah. Next question.
This question is from John, John Lilo.
Thank you for the question.
What is your favorite place to eat in the West? Favorite place?
I think our...
There's so many.
Both our favorite one is Big Chiefs.
Yeah, Big Chiefs for like takeaway. For breakfast, I'd say like Lucy's Cafe in Mount Druitt. Yeah, I think that's about it. Oh, and... Man, have you ever had the chicken katsu from the sushi place in Mount Druitt next to Basil and Lime? And have it, that's like my favourite, yeah. The chicken katsu there.
But yeah, also I like the steak from the village.
Mm.
But yeah, it's cook your own steak, but it's nice. It's like a buffet
style. How much is it now? It feels like $12 now or something.
It's still pretty cheap, eh?
Yeah, but freaking back in the days it used to be $6.
It's not back in the days. Next.
This question is from Zora. What traits are most important to you in your family members?
Ooh, that's a good one.
For me is loyalty, honesty. That's pretty much it for me. And your family members, yeah. That's all you could ask for. This one's from the devil. Gyo. Who's the real boss, you or the black sheep?
I think we're 50-50, eh?
Yeah, well, it's...
Yeah.
Like, if Sally tells me, like, to come home, like, if I'm out somewhere, and, like, drinking or something...
This guy never fold, man.
He'll never be like, fold, baby!
He'll say, yeah, I'm on my way, and then I'll fall asleep. And I go, you're not here. And it's 6 a.m. in the morning.
Yeah, I'm on my way.
And then, but yeah, no, I think we're 50-50 in the relationship. Yeah.
That's it. That's how it should be.
Yep. Next question.
This one's from Anna.
Anna.
What's your favorite island or food?
Ooh.
You go first.
Oh. So many, but but I can't believe it, but I really love bisupo and falifufai, those two together, yum.
But why can't you believe it?
Because everyone's like bisupo. Oh, and also there's luau. I love luau.
That's mine. Yeah. I'll be luau and galu. That's the best combo in the island of food industry, mate.
But do you like luau, the Samoan one, or the Tonga one? Because the Tonga one, they have meat in it.
Love me some Tongan ones. Yeah. I don't know what I said. Nah, it's funny. I only said that because Sally asked me like before, like, oh, what kind of girls? Like, what's your favorite Tonga girls? And I said Tonga.
And then I was like, well, are you with a Tongan?
Hey, my little Pito.
Oh, we got our last question.
Last one. from Alex. This one's for, I don't know if it's for me or Sally. Are you going to make a rugby comeback after baby number two?
I don't think I will make a comeback, but mostly for fitness. I think that's the only way I could stay fit is football. So yeah, I would definitely come back to football, but I don't think 2020 is the year. I think 2021, because it's almost half of the year. But yeah, I would love to get back into rugby, yes.
So thanks to everyone who sent in their questions. We had an awesome time reading it, and hopefully that gave you, you know, a bit of more insight about us and what we're up to.
Yeah, so just before we go, we'd like to ask you guys to please like, subscribe, and comment below, just to let us know how you guys thought about our first vlog and how we did, what you'd like to see more from me and Layne.
There's nothing too serious, hey?
Yeah.
Just turn that camera on, get in front of it, and talk some smack.
Yeah, and we'd just like to thank you guys for viewing our channel. Also, if you'd like to check us out on our social medias, that'll be posted down in the description box. Other than that, just keep an eye out on our next vlog, and bye for now.
Vows.
Bye. That's my just like that.